Hey everybody, this is Talkative Carl back again playing some more God of War Ragnarok Valhalla. I'm streaming a little late, just slightly, because I woke up most of the day with like a huge headache. I mean, I didn't drink enough water the night before, so I couldn't get enough done-wise as much as I'd like to. So, I'm probably gonna just leave that for tomorrow. But anyway, let's get right into it with more Valhalla. I was dreaming I was in Mummy 3. Okay.
Much better than last time. It seems you're learning Valhalla's rules.
Where is Freya?
Away for the moment. As you know, she's attending to many things presently. Establishing a new governing body for the realms is no simple task. There are leaders to find and recruit, negotiations for sharing power. I'm sure she'd prefer to be here, but we'll have to make do with the three of us for now.
I'm sure we're in excellent hands.
Vigilance Part 2.
If you keep going back in, I take it this process is working for you somehow. Yes. Succeed or fail. I feel progress. Clarity. I need to see it through. Very good, brother.
What the deuce is this? A shield?
An infamous act. One that shields Bolvar from the years of rebuilding. Somehow the island ended its own.
I'll give you this, brother. The technique is improved immeasurably.
I need his power to secure my vengeance against the gods. I believed I had no choice.
What choice? You could have not let Fire Hill off your body. That was absolutely the option. And he's back. But that wasn't the worst of it, was it, Kratos? Killing you deprived Greece of the sun. It would plunge the temperature into cold and darkness. Crops ceased to grow. Famine descended on our homeland. Now that you came, enough. It's better than using it.
Yeah, I mean, you can hardly, he is bitter, but you can hardly say he had no right to be a little angry. Not the fact that you killed him, but the fact that because of his death plunged the civilization of Greece into perpetual darkness and famine, and it's kind of like the need of the sun to help crops grow. So it's like you can't judge him like too harshly, because you know Kratos was blinded by vengeance. It's hard you could blame him. So it goes to show like vengeance, you know, doesn't serve a greater purpose than your own satisfaction.
Kratos, I'm here. Your decision to behead humans, was it fueled by any personal motivations? Was it really just a means to an end?
It was not personal. I did know him long before I killed him. He was as insufferable as any god. But his death brought me no satisfaction.
Did you know what would happen as a result?
When Helios was captured by the god of dreams, the lands fell into darkness. And will not restore it until his return. I knew exactly what would happen.
Wow.
Seems busted you're a button for the time to receive a greater reward. Will you attempt it? This time around, baby.
I mean, like, Kilios is a dick, but his death, like you said, then wouldn't have, you know, made him feel any better, despite him needing his power. Because, like, every time I choose, it's kind of replaces one, doesn't it? Or it just goes to another slot. I don't know.
Hesitant as you do. I feared that taking the throne would only validate Odin's power hierarchy, which even then I didn't trust. But I decided I could wield a better influence on the inside than on the outside. There are many ways to lead, and not all of them involve ruling. The throne and the office are only what you bring to them.
Don't need that. What's behind here? Boss fight.
There's the one Valhalla's box.
Oh, that's cheap. Gotcha.
What?
Alright, where'd he go?
Watch it.
So any health things? There's one.
Now then, the pass should be unlocked. Let's make a way up.
Magni, Modi. Did not see that one coming. Modi. It is hard to see any similarities between Modi and his sister Third. She shares none of his cruelty, nor his cowardice. I know you still harbor much guilt over his killing, as do I, for my role in it. Like his brother, Valhalla manifests him from my memory to fight once again.
You're not done with me yet, Kratos. And lest we forget, Kratos, lest we neglect to face your deed in full and proper context, I saved your life. Me! And you literally tore off my head for my troubles. Imagine if all your new friends knew how you used to treat your old friends. Of course, you're not the same man, right? Ah, you almost had your friends killed through lack of foresight. Far easier to blame others that way, am I right?
I know you are a projection of mind. But for what it is worth, the death I gave you was unjust.
Oh, how touching. Yeah. Not actually worth the spittle to mumble that out.
Do not do that again. Nobody wants to hear that from you.
mean, yeah, I had my doubts he would accept that apology, as much of an apology Kratos will muster for anybody. But it was, you know, more so for his own. When he was giving an apology, it's more so for your own recognition that you done wrong, even if the other person won't accept it. Just an acknowledgement that you effed up.
Something to remember by. I truly hope it brings you unrelenting torment. Jeez, you just don't enjoy that, doesn't it? Feels like judgment.
Helios is healed. Found another object from my past in Valhalla, a shield once owned by the sun god Helios. It is trampled and useless now, a bitter reminder of my reckless actions in the time I was driven only by misguided anger.
Getting a choice regarding your fate must be nice.
Let's see what's up. This thing. Wraith. These vengeful ghosts are restless spirits caught between two worlds. Their bodies went unburied or were buried improperly, so they return to torment the living. In Valhalla, they are every bit as aggressive and full of rage as I remember.
Yeah.
Minotaur. Miss my time. Minotaur. It was Ares who first bred these horned beasts to serve in his army. Their effectiveness soon led to their use across most of my homeland's armies. Different breeds were developed to serve different roles. I was never once tempted to use them in my own army. They are far too dim-witted and unpredictable. The Aegean boat can be found in the east wing. Yeah. Good lord. Well, actually,
yeah.
grew up in a race for not so savage ways. Always looking for an edge. Is this a game to you?
There you go.
Ah, hello, come back. I'm back. Ah, yen another gun. I have another cherished weapon for my travels to show you. Ready to see.
Egyptian. Copus.
I'm back now.
Retribution. That is not what I am. I'm not going to be in my home. You've stolen David Oden. bringing the darkness over everything you can see.
That was close.
I yield. Good day. I don't think you were indifferent, Kratos. I think you were hurt. Deeply hurt. And you handled it unskillfully. Wait, is that you restoring the sun? You took Helios' giant and put the sun back in the sky. Sacrifice yourself in the process.
Yes, I fell to my death and was saved by Helios. But this barely happened before I killed him. My evils are yet to come. At this point,
that your legacy had always been a complicated one. That goodness is not a destination we arrive at, but a practice. Misfortune may drive anyone to darkness. We resist it only through wisdom and vigilance. You are not so unskillful now as you were then. Better voices in your head, you may call it. I think that's enough for now. You have much to contemplate. Yes. Back to the beach then. You should be proud of your progress, Krios. See you soon.
It seems like you're making progress, whatever you're doing in there.
Perhaps.
Listen, I know I made you feel like we expected more of you than you could give. And I just want you to know, I'm not asking you to change how you are or who you are. We had to break the old world to build a new one. Picking up the pieces and putting them together stronger, it's a rare opportunity. You made a difference here. In some circles, a symbol of change. On many days, just knowing that you're a part of the council is enough.
End of the days.
You've earned a voice. How you use it is up to you.
To adapt this domain to the alchemy of turning adversity into advantage.
Brass of Zeus. How's that different from what I got right now?
Investment.
go one more round. This is what I want. No. This is what I want. This one I always use. I don't have it. Don't know why it never occurred. Where the Valkyrie's at? Benevolence. Yes, thank you. I love that one. Pandora.
A substitute daughter. The box full of evils. This one feels important.
This is your blacksmith story, isn't it? His goal is the E. And he died protecting her?
Protecting her from me. I hope that that boss remains to kill Ares. And what I released
pretty much to all of our defense.
Defense against that.
Quiet, Ares.
Unfortunate. The time I spend in my own Valhalla means you get more time with him.
She ain't gonna do that.
Yeah!
like, get this dude off of me. Magni, Valhalla has drawn the son of Thor from my memory to do battle. He is still as arrogant, cruel, and boastful as he was in life. I know he suffered much abuse at the hands of his own father. While it does not excuse his behavior, it does at least make it easier to understand. Oh yeah.
I'm not to bless your day.
Righteous haranguing that I have evil the gods are, and you somehow gloss over that little extra nudge you gave them.
Opening the box was a Venus plan. I did not know the consequences.
Coward plain ignorance of the consequences of trusting Athena? Is that your idea of a joke, Kratos? Because I think it's hilarious. But let's be real, Kratos. Whether you should have suspected the consequences or not, you certainly can't claim that you would have cared about them. You wanted the power to kill Ares. And because you wanted it, everything is justified. That's your moral code at the end of the day, isn't it?
To imagine you once again holding an office of solemn metaphysical responsibility.
A trusted figure. A worshipped figure.
The absolute god of you to let yourself consider such a thing. His irony can have you when it earns you something. What will he choose?
Oh.
That's funny how Helios turned his words back at him. Or at least twisted it. Because I love that line, death can have me when it earns me. I guess irony can have you when it earns you or something. No cradles, no scry. Pandora's statue. Another object from my past has manifested within Valhalla. This one is a replica of the statues I encountered in my search for Pandora's box. They were carved by the god Hephaestus in an attempt to recreate his daughter Pandora. It brings back memories I would sooner forget. Recognize this before. I was wondering if that would work or not.
Yes.
Centaur, okay. Not all centaurs are as brainless and vicious as the ones I have fought. From the forest of Mount Pelion, centaurs were well known for their poetry and winemaking. But when the Lepus encroached on their forest, they took up arms. It was not long before they were being recruited across Greece for their martial prowess.
Is my idea done with? Quickly!
before it closes in.
Guess you think you're new to our heart now.
Darn it.
Gotcha.
Perfect timing.
Watch out for me!
Decisions.
That's gonna have to do.
Oh, back again. Still not used to that. Welcome back. I have one last weapon to show you. I think you'll enjoy it, if that's the word.
Japanese katana. God.
Yeah, by this point you set the down, you'll pick up self-improvements. Shall we make a bargain?
The focus is paying off.
Is offering some help. I take it.
I'm gonna save up for a resurrection stone. They're gonna end the video here. Yeah, like a huge buff for some freaking reason. But I think we're gonna end it here. Yeah, I'll be back tomorrow for more God of War. He got a freaking Japanese katana, Egyptian compass. It makes sense because he's traveled all over different cultures, learning all the you know everything that is about them, including their battle strategies and armaments. Makes sense. You have Mokuto from the Mayan culture. You got the Copus from Egyptian katana from Japanese culture, so it's like, man. But anyway, I'll see you guys tomorrow and see how much we can get through, get past that point, because we're probably nearly done. But anyway, I'll see you guys soon. Have a good night.